please welcome from The Killers, Brandon Flowers. Welcome.
Thanks. Thanks for
having
me.
She's got a question for you.
Yes.
Well, yes, actually, I do. you know, why? I mean, did you ever get this question about what your relationship to classical music was, or to classical musicians, or to classical composers?
No. No.
You were right.
Are you sure?
I don't think I've ever been asked my relationship to any classical composer.
But do you have any relationship to any?
I took piano lessons as a kid. And so I learned, you know, some pieces from a few different, maybe from Bach and Mozart and things. But I didn't, but I don't have a, I don't know if that led into what I do now or not. I'm sure it had some sort of impact.
Your album is called Battleborn. What is the battle?
Well, it stems from on the Nevada state flag, which is, we're from Nevada, The Killers. And Battleborn is written on the flag. And it became a state out of the Civil War. But that's not what the record is about. it's a part of our heritage and been a part of our life growing up and seeing that flag every day. And we thought it was a great time to name the record.
You actually grew up in Las Vegas.
Yeah.
The city of sin.
Mm-hmm.
and you still live there with your family and with
I can't leave it. I just can't.
But you got the three kids. I mean, do they have kindergartens in Las Vegas?
They do. My oldest just started preschool, and he will go on to kindergarten.
And then to the casino, or is it?
A lot of us have family that worked in casinos, and our drummer's mother is still a cocktail waitress at Caesar's Palace. Up until recently, my dad was a bellman at Treasure Island. I worked as a bellman in the Gold Coast. So yeah, I mean, it's definitely, the pulse of Las Vegas is the Strip, I guess.
But how is family life there? I mean, your family is back in Las Vegas now,
mm-hmm.
and you're sitting here.
Yeah.
How are they, do you think? What's happening?
Well, we're 9 hours ahead, so it's pretty early there. But it's, I don't know, it's difficult for my wife, you know, and the three boys, I miss them every day.
You're homesick?
Yes.
I'm on tour constantly.
Yeah, it takes some getting used to.
You are actually a Mormon, and you've been a Mormon also for your whole life.
Mm-hmm.
Can you please explain the beauty of faith
to
Bjorn
faith.
Here? He's an atheist.
The beauty of faith. Some of the things that I love are, I think about my mother teaching me to pray and that I had that communication with my Heavenly Father. And that's something that I turn to on a daily basis. And just there are answers to questions that my church has that also are very, I guess it's a beautiful thing. It's a beautiful thing for me. And I'm happy, so.
Do you find it difficult to, when you're traveling around like this and you give interviews and you meet people,
mm-hmm.
do you feel like you have to represent the Mormons? Because you're a very famous Mormon, but also a rock star.
Yeah, it's difficult because I'm here to promote this band, and then I get questions a lot about being a Mormon. But it's understandable because it's still a very misunderstood sort of religion, and I think people are pretty unfamiliar with it. So I don't. It doesn't bother me.
Do you think it's more to do with the fact that people don't associate rock and roll with any kind of the rock and roll lifestyle with any kind of faith? So it's more that it's less of the division or the lack of connection between Mormons and rock and roll, but more the bigger picture. We don't expect someone in leathers like that to be praying to.
Yeah, that could be part of it. I mean, I think a lot of people are religious and other people that are in my line of business, but for some reason it's something that people gravitate toward. About myself.
Mm. Are you a religious person, Vilde?
Yes, I do. I do believe in God. But I am not serving him every Sunday. I mean, I have a pretty much unstructured relationship to God, but I know he's there whenever I want him, so I'm pretty spoiled.
What nice comfort that must be. Now, my question for you was, I'm curious to know, do you actually literally believe in the story about Joseph Smith and the gold plates and the hat and everything?
Yeah, I'm very familiar with the origins of my religion, and and I've read about it. You get to that age where you have to, you know, your parents teach you something, and you've got to decide once you're an adult, you know. You can't just go off of what they said. You have to gain a testimony for yourself. And I believe Joseph Smith.
You might be about to have your first Mormon president, Mitt Romney. Have you met him?
I have.
How is he? Except from being a Mormon.
Very rich.
He was a cordial guy. I've met Obama, also a very cordial guy. They both look good in suits.
did Mr. Romney ask you to support him?
There've been some talks, I think, but you know, the whole band isn't Mormon, and the whole band, we're not divided necessarily, but we all have our different opinions on things, and we're pretty much standing on neutral ground when it comes to this stuff.
You're not secular. Like a Mormon band.
Yeah, we're a secular band. We're new, you know, the Switzerland of bands. We're neutral here.
So you had to turn him down.
Yeah, politely, you know. We would support our president. We had a great opportunity to play the White House on the 4th of July a couple years back for the USO, for the soldiers, and that was one of the highlights of our career so far, so.
It's so great having you here. I'm going to say something in Norwegian now. Don't go, okay? Please welcome E.L. James.